Hello everyone, especially Principal College Wayanad WMO Muttil College, Noorjahan and her colleagues, and of course my colleagues here, and Father Joy James. I understand that he is there, and all those who have signed in for this webinar. I would like to begin by congratulating the Department of Social Work in Muttil College for initiating such a series of programs. That is definitely commendable, and I'm proud that it is done by one of our alumni, Noorjahan. I'm happy for you and the department and the profession as well. So for that as the beginning, I'll get on with my presentation, or rather my seminar. Today I'll be, as Noorjahan said, I've taught her, and Father Joy James have taught me. So it is like three generations of, and we have, I think, one more generation listening to us. So it is a great privilege and opportunity. And for me personally, it is another, it is the beginning of another level of learning, because I am not used to dealing with this new technology of online communication and all that. So this is a beginning for me also. Anyway, let us move on to our topic. Today I'll be talking about community organization models, and as Noorjahan said, it will only be an introduction to the models, because there are a number of models. Lots of authors, social workers have developed models over time, right from Murray G. Rose, and we are still developing new models. So we will not be going into that. This will be an introduction which will help our listeners, our students, to read more on models, and that they can take it up from there. And of course, they can supplement these theoretical inputs with the their experience or learning from the field where they're working. So today I'll be talking about why the structure of the presentation will be like this. I'll be telling you about, you know, why we use models first. Endinana models nalladu, the need and significance of models, and what exactly is a model. And then in detail we'll discuss the first very clearly delineated model of community organization given by Jack Roth. And of course, there were previous models, but they were not that clearly established. Rothman's models are used as a reference point for the later models. So we first learn that. So that will help everybody who's a student of community organization to further develop their understanding of what actual practice models of community organization. So we'll deal with the community organization models delineated by Rothman in detail. We'll also briefly mention about other major models, and how do we choose models. That also we'll discuss in brief. That is how we'll be concluding. I would like to say in the beginning itself that I am an academician out and out. For the last few years, I have not been in touch with the actual practice situations apart from guiding our students in supervision, their fieldwork activity. So that is a problem. So I am not very familiar, or I am not an expert, I would like to say, in the actual implementation of models in the field. So that is a problem. I have told Noorjahan about that also. First, but we'll look at the theoretical aspect. So that will help us to move on to further things. Okay. So what are actually models? We have. I think all the methods of social work have models. Model is a conceptual framework of how things are constructed. You know, it helps us in understanding a reality in a more concrete manner. Because in classrooms, we learn about conditions, people's lives, the theories and all. But when we put it into practice, we need certain frameworks to understand it more. So if there is a model, it is easy for us to understand. So it is a conceptual or a theoretical framework. It provides us a design about how to think and approach a problem. All of you know that community organization, we practice in communities, which are very complex entities. Of course, individuals and groups are complex entities, but I would say communities have a larger scope, and you know, they are more complicated and more complex. There are a number of institutions, individuals, and their interrelationships. So problems in communities, when we address them, it becomes very complicated and complex. So to understand such a complex reality, we need, if there are certain ready-made, you know, like, you know, ready reckoner kind of thing, it will help us to understand that reality better. So the models are actually meant to provide us a design for how to think and to understand the structure and of these interrelatedness. So this will help us in the words of Weil, who's developed a very, Mary Weil, she has developed a very clear set of models later on. She has said that, you know, they illustrate the diverse ways that community practice is concerned. So one thing I would like to tell my audience or participants of the seminar is that community organization can be done in a different number of different ways. And it is natural only. Because unlike other spaces where we work, communities are very fluid. You know, they are not static, permanent structures. And the communities we have known, you know, the textbook definitions we have learned of communities. All of you will be knowing that those definitions: group of people living together in a territorially defined space. And who are having a sense of we feeling. That is how we have all learned about community. But do such communities exist now? Or this definition, these features of this definition, does it apply to the communities in the total sense of those definitions? Communities are changing in terms of their heterogeneity, in terms of their the sense of togetherness. And we have more newer and newer forms of community. All those definition-based communities, it's like a romantic, nostalgic past. We have different types of communities. Naturally, working with communities also will require us to work in different ways. There is no one single way you can work with communities. There are different ways and ways to organize communities. So that is what we are going to see in models. Instead of looking at communities and community practice with one lens or one method or one way of doing it, we can work with communities with a number of methods. So that is where models come. And there are different approaches. You can have small community groups, you can have larger government intervention programs, we can have social action models. There are different models of community organization like that. And these models were It actually started forming with, you all know about settlement house movement and then charity organization, and then later on rural development, community development approaches. All this have led the way to the delineation of models. Murreji Rose has given a very rudimentary primary kind of method, model delineation. But we are today discussing Jack Rothman. In 1967, Jack Rothman came up with a three-model structure, which is, I'm sure those who are current students of social work would know that, because it is part of your syllabus and your curriculum. They are locality development, social planning, and social action. So this set of models, as I said earlier, it is the basic reference point for other models also. So I'll share a few PowerPoint slides so that this becomes. Okay, I hope you can see the slides.
Yes, miss.
Okay. We use models, as I said, for understanding our role, how to look at communities, how to conceive our practice. That is why we use models. And Rothman's models of community organization This was developed in 67-68. It is a three-pronged model, and they are locality development, social planning, and social action. So the first one is locality development. The locality development, the emphasis is on community building, that the traditional definition kind of community. Our goal will be improving the community competency and social integration in the community. I'll elaborate further. The second is data-based problem-solving orientation of social planning, social policy with its reliance on expertise. We rely more on data, that is massive data generated from the field where we are working, and using the data and research as a base and the technical expertise, we deal with problems. That is the second model. And third model is the advocacy social action model, where we try to bring about So, Noorjahan, can you hear me?
Yes, miss. Yes. No? Ah, yes. Okay.
There might be a problem with our net connectivity today, so that is why I'm asking. Okay. Yes. So So advocacy social action mode, we our focus is on fundamental change rather than working with the smaller systems to bring about cosmetic, or I wouldn't say cosmetic, incremental changes. We look at fundamental changes. We look at social justice. So these are the basic three prongs. And of course, we'll look at locality development in nature, which is one of the most commonly used models in community organization. I'm sure students, when they work during their studies, when they go for fieldwork, when they work with NGOs, they'll be definitely seeing this model in practice. So locality model presupposes that we bring about changes in the community through people's participation. So I would say locality development, one of the cornerstones of locality development is that it is people initiated, people directed. Okay, so it is conceived ideally as an ideal type. It is conceived by the people, and it is taken further and forward by the people of the community, the people who are in the community. And the role of the social worker is rather that of a facilitator who initiates the change. The people determine goals, they take action. And this process is not simply to achieve that goal. The process is also to build that community to become a stronger community. Okay, in the process of dealing with the problem through people's participation and involvement, the another major important thing is that this leads to community building also. Okay, so it fosters community building by promoting the process goals of community organization, that is community's competency, the ability to solve problems on a self-help basis. This is very important. This is, all of us know that we as social workers, we believe in self-help, we propagate, we live by that ideal. We want all our client systems to become self-reliant and able to deal with their problems themselves. So here that happens. In this model, the focus is on that. We want the community to become stronger community by being more competent to deal with their problems by themselves. And also,
can I do a small announcement? We have a small technical issue that is related with Zoom. Actually, okay. Zoom is providing 40-minute session, free session. Yeah. So sometime this session will be ending now. Sometime, okay. I don't know. Sometime we'll get extension automatically. Okay. So if it is ending now, then we can use the same link to enter to the next session.
Okay.
Okay. Fine. So I want to inform all the participants. Okay.
Okay. Thank you.
If that is not ending, then there is no problem.
Okay. Fine.
Okay. Thank you.
So thank you. So I'll continue. So one of our process goals in locality development is that our community becomes a stronger community. Second is social of different, we live in a multicultural society today, very diverse society today. So naturally, there'll be the interrelationships between these people and their institutions is that what makes the community. So having creating more better relation, harmonious relationships among these different racial, ethnic, social, caste and religious groups and everybody in the community will be another goal of this model of community organization. And the people, I told you, it is run by the people. So the leadership is drawn from within. Sometimes it can also be possible that, you know, the social worker is also from the same community. But usually it is not so. We are usually outsiders working with the community. So the direction and the control of the development process or the social work intervention will be with the people. So that is the first model. Small communities, people come together to deal with problems, and in the process they become a stronger and more integrated community. That is the first model. The second is, as you know, it is social planning. It is more technocratic in nature, and it's more rational and that kind of a thing. The focus is on a technical process of problem solving. We use rationality, logic, and modern, you know, approaches to dealing with problems. Like, you know, we have lots of technology kind of things. We use that to deal with problems, because some of the problems cannot be dealt with at the local small community level.
Excuse me, miss.
Yeah.
Can you ഇപ്പോ ആ പി പി ടി ഷെയർ ചെയ്യുന്നത് നമുക്ക് വിസിബിൾ അല്ല, ഒന്ന് സ്റ്റോപ്പ് ചെയ്തിട്ട് ഒന്നുകൂടെ ഷെയർ ചെയ്യോ?
ചെയ്യാം.
Even now it is not visible.
Can you see it now?
Dr. Jaya, that you have to press that the green button, share screen.
Yeah, that I have done.
You're done? Okay.
Yeah.
It is not seen here.
I'll go to that once again and then do it. Once again. Okay, share screen. And I've selected this PowerPoint and then I've given...
You have to put the share the screen.
Okay.
There's a green button below.
Okay. Yeah. Can you see it now?
Even that is not visible now.
See, what I select the PowerPoint on the desktop and then give share. That is what I do. Is that okay? Is that how it is done?
Yeah, angathaneyanu cheyyendathu pakshe miss onnu just meeting leave edittu onnode join cheyyo.
Cheyyam.
Okay.
Okay.
Jamis, please try now.
Yeah. One second.
Yeah.
Yes. How about now?
Yeah, yeah.
Yeah. Can see now this? It's okay. So now we can see.
Okay, thank you. So we move on to the second model, which is the social planning model. And this is used, or this we have seen in practice, where we are dealing with larger social problems, like, you know, housing, health, delinquency, social welfare issues usually. There you need a massive amount of data and comprehensive attempts to deal with the problem, rather than the smaller community kind of approaches. So this is data driven. You know, you need a lot of information about the ground realities. So that is collected first, and using that and the expertise of different professionals, not only social worker, so many other professionals are involved, and that is used to deal with the problem. So we can have examples from our health sector. Is there any problem? Is it okay?
Yeah, yeah. Please continue.
Okay. So one example I would like to give is the programs in our health sector. We have a massive healthcare system, and every year we come up with new programs. And we do this using a lot of data, and social worker is actually part of a team where so many other professionals are working. Like, you know, what we have in, I don't know whether it is a very apt kind of a example, NHM is one example where social workers are also working along with doctors and statisticians and other social scientists in dealing with public health issues. Okay, so bringing or ensuring public health and general health of people, we need to have larger comprehensive approaches. That is where this model of social planning is coming. In this model, the social worker is one of the, like, you know, that person is not the primary functionary. That is one thing we have to remember. So it is very technocratic and rational. And another differentiating feature is that community participation is not a core ingredient in this. Of course, it will be better if there is participation, but there can be programs with minimum level of participation. Participation, as beneficiaries, most of the social planning models, they see their people, their clients as beneficiaries or service users. So participation as such, you know, as that ideal participation, we don't see in social planning. So that is, I would say, one of the weaknesses also of this thing. I can't move it to the next slide. There is some problem. So social planning, yeah. Social planning also presupposes that, there should be other experts who, through the exercise of technical competencies, they are needed to improve the social conditions. There is a lot of reliance on needs assessment. I said, you know, a lot of data collection, baseline information collection and all that. And based on that, the decision analysis, evaluation, research, etc. The goals will be delivering of these goods and services to people who need them, whether that is healthcare, whether that is specialized services like, you know, programs for children who are in trouble, who are in conflict with law, things like that, it is given to them. And we also work with a number of agencies are coordinated at the ground level. It is not one single department or one organization doing this. There is a lot of coordination among agencies to avoid duplication and, you know, and to fill gaps in service. So that is the second one. Then we have the social action model. This is, of course, we are all familiar with the idea of social action. So this, as I said in the beginning, this looks at issues on more of a fundamental change kind of thing. You need to bring about social justice to deal with problems, rather than dealing with small group issues or massive health massive problems using government machinery and scientific expertise. Here we are dealing with situations where there is There should be change in the existing institutions, whether that is government or our value systems or attitudes. There should be basic change. That is the idea. So in this, we organize an aggrieved or a disadvantaged segment of the population in order to make demands on the larger community. Usually it is usually the full state or the country, for increased resources and equal treatment. It has a militant, I would say, militant is a word I've taken from Jagar Othman. I would say it has a political edge. This model of community organization, unlike any other models, has got a really real political edge to it, because we are dealing with structures of power, inequalities, and things like that. So there is a militant orientation to advocacy. We are pressurizing institutions and systems and individuals to bring about change. So this aims at making fundamental changes in the community, including the redistribution of power and resources, and gaining access to decision making for marginal groups. We try to bring about changes in the already existing policies, legislations. It can be a local panchayat, it can be a local municipality at the basic level. It can be a state government, one department. It can be the national government also. We can put pressure on these institutions for bringing about change in certain practices, certain measures, certain policies. Okay, so practitioners of this model try to empower and benefit the poor, the disadvantaged, and the oppressed. When I say poor, it is not in that narrow sense of our definition of poverty. It talks about all kinds of deprivation and vulnerability. And this model is very conflictual, and social justice is a major goal. We use tactics like, pressure tactics like picketing and marches and civil disobedience and things like that. There is a whole range of tactics. And this model has been used by a number of NGOs who are working with, AIDS activists, feminist organizing groups, environmental groups, consumer protection, human rights groups have been using this model as a very powerful weapon. So these are the three basic models. You can see that these models don't exist in isolation. Okay, they interact and they intermix actually. They cut across each other in real practice. We were talking about the theoretical delineation of models, but that is in theory. In real practice, there is no organization which uses only locality development and only social planning. We see in actual practice that organizations use many times two and sometimes even three models of community organization. These models are used in differing situations. They don't exist in isolation. They overlap and intermix. And we can see that, maybe you start with a small locality development activity, move on to social planning and social action, or vice versa. That can happen. It is common. And in actual organizations and ongoing projects, we see all these approaches, elements of these approaches getting combined. So how do we understand which model we are using? I've prepared a small template which will give you a little more clearer idea of how certain variables are different in all these. Show you that I'll be talking about the goal of the model, the role of the social worker, and who are the constituents, or who are the stake, who are the, I would say, beneficiaries or clients. Who are the clients and what are we trying to change, and what is a change strategy? These five variables are different for all the three models. Okay, so what are we trying to achieve? For locality development, I said it is community capacity and social community integration. That is our goal. Rather than simply solving the problem, we look at a higher goal. But in social action, our goal is more fundamental. We try to bring about more equitable distribution of resources. We try to influence power dynamics. We try to bring about social justice. And in social planning, the goal is more concrete and technical. It is social change, sorry, problem solving. A specific problem we try to, I talked about public health issues. So we deal with the public health issue. We are right now, it is the right time to talk about a public health issue as an example. I will come to that later. Then the role of the practitioner is also different. I think I've got another 5 minutes to complete this. Do I have 5 more minutes?
Yes, miss, you can.
Okay. So the role of the social worker is also different. In the locality development model, the social worker is an enabler, a facilitator, the person who begins or triggers the change process and who coordinates activities. But in social action, you can see it is very different. The social worker is a negotiator, an activist, and an advocate. We talk for other people. You know, we talk for people who don't have voices. Okay. And then social planning. Our role is more of a manager, I would say. And most of our social workers are right now, at least in Kerala, a large number of our social workers are in this capacity. We work as experts. We work as researchers, data analysts, managing and that kind of things are done by the social worker in when we are using the social planning model. And who are our
Shweb sir?
Yes.
I think Jamis voice has some problem.
I think so. I'll call her.
Dr. Jaya, can you hear? Dr. Jaya, can you hear us? I think she has left.
Call her, sir, father. I think she already told that there is a problem with the network.
Okay. I think she has left the group.
Yeah.
Because we don't see her face.
Yeah. Let me call her.
She's not there in the meeting. We'll call her.
Okay. Don't worry. Take your time. Okay. Bye. Ah, yes. It is up. There are. Okay. So, that is disconnect ay poyadana. She is trying to reconnect it. She'll be back soon. Sorry for the inconvenience. This is all technical issues.
Actually, it's a part of online session.
Can we start some discussion so that she can join us?
Yeah, sure, Father.
Are you okay?
Yes, Father, we can discuss till she joins.
Okay. So, this it was a beautiful presentation. Unfortunately, she can't hear what we are saying. On the Jack Prothman's model. Now, one thing that we must understand, our approach, the whole approach, whether we select the model or the method, depends on our perception of the client, the choice of the client. And the social work, we say that when we have a problem with individual or families, we choose the social casework method. And when we are dealing with the groups, because we find that a group is much better for a human development because interaction is there, so that is the social group work approach. Then our client is a community, smaller or bigger, rural or urban. Then we use the community organization. One of the things that we understand that most colleges, most departments teach six methods of social work. It was the first time Jack Prothman said there are only three models. casework, group work and community organization. Social action is not a separate model. It is one of the separate method. It is one of the models in community organization. That was a great intervention in the 1970s. Then social research also is not a method because it enhances the work, our intervention. So there are only three basic methods and one ancillary method where we will deal with the organization aspect. This is the first understanding. Oh, Dr. Jaya is back. Okay.
Okay.
I was just trying to reflect on
that. Okay. I know. Thank you yeah. for that.
Okay.
I think I'll try to finish it fast. I'll share that screen also. Okay. Is this, can everybody see this?
Yes, yes.
Okay. So we were talking about social action as a model and, how these models are intermixed by organizations and the different variables or different, how do we differentiate these in terms of certain variables? And the target of, I'll continue from there, the target of change of these, all these models are different. In locality development, we try to bring about certain better services to a community. That is our target of change. And power structure, our target is the power structure in community, in social action. And we try to target social institutions so that they change or they modify or they perform better. And it can be, when I say social institutions, I'm talking about, the state, and even institutions like family, things like that. And in social planning also, there is a mistake. Social planning, we look at creating programs or services for our clientele.
James, can you put it in a slideshow?
Yeah, okay. Oh, it is not in slideshow. Fine. Then the change strategies also we use are different. In locality development, we try to use consensus as a strategy. We try to bring people together, help them to overcome their difficulties in working together, and try to reach consensus. ഒരു സമവായം ആണ് നമ്മുടെ ലക്ഷ്യം. എല്ലാവർക്കും ബോധ്യമായ കാര്യങ്ങളിലൂടെ, that is how we integrate the community. In social action, we try to our strategy is to mobilize people to take action against the powerful. Powerful meaning, anybody who's an agent of oppression. Okay, it can be an individual, it can be a corporate, it can be a government. Okay, and in social planning, our strategy is collecting data and data analysis and logical, rational problem solving techniques. Okay, so Rothman has revised or modified these basic models later. In 2007, but it corresponds to the original models. He is talking about community capacity development as opposed to locality development, and then planning and policy in the place of social planning, and social advocacy in the place of social action. But to a great extent, there is a lot of similarity with this original model. And there are some other models. I'll just briefly tell you about that so that you can look it up later. Please definitely read on this. Weil and Gamble developed a typology in 95. They've prepared an 8 model because Rothman's models are, there are only 3. As I said in the beginning, there are lots of ways of working with the community. So limiting it to 3 was found to be insufficient by many later thinkers or writers who develop models. So they have developed an 8 model framework. Some of them are similar to Rothman's models. We have neighborhood and community organizing, definitely that looks like locality development. Then organizing functional communities. I'm sure all of you know that we have functional communities also, rather than only having geographical communities. We don't live in physical spaces anymore. We live in a virtual world. We live we live online actually. We can have communities across the world. We can be part of communities anywhere in the world. So people with similar interests are called functional communities. there are a number of organizations who work with functional communities. Okay. You can't hear me?
Yes.
Okay. So one example will be, I would say, transgender. Right now, lots of organizations are working with transgender. They are not geographically limited, you know. They're working with the interests of this LGBTQ communities all over the country or all over the place. So they are functional. That's one example of a functional community. Then community, social and economic development. This actually is more like our poverty eradication programs. We are the community development program we have implemented in India is kind of this model. Okay, we work with people to improve their income, improve their livelihood so that they overcome poverty and other deprivations. Then social planning, of course, we know. Then program development and community liaison. This is not very regularly used in India, but you know, sometimes certain, I've read examples like American Peace Corps and all. They come to a community during maybe a disaster, they come to a community, they work with them. But later on they develop, they identify a need in the community and later on they build on that to provide a program. Then political and social action, we have discussed. Then coalitions is a newer addition. Because problems are very complex and you know realities are very difficult, it is better to work with people of similar interests. We have our examples in front of us. You know, we have coalitions of environment movements or NGOs working with environment movements, human rights organizations. So they come together and work, which will make a better impact. And then, of course, social movements. Coalitions later on become social movements. That is what I have seen. A larger change efforts are called as social movements. So these are the models given by Mary White. Then Ann Jeffries has proposed a four-square model. You can just look at it. One is nonviolent direct action, coalition building and campaigns, capacity and awareness, partnership and promotion. These are the things. So how do we choose a model? That is our, that will be the last thing. You cannot say that, okay, I'm going to work with the community, I'll be working only with this model. You cannot say that. Our choice of model depends on a number of things, actually. First thing is, what is, you know, who employs us? What is the mission of our employer? And you know, the community organization is organizer is working with an NGO or a state-run organization. So what is the mission of that organization depends. You're working with a state institution. You cannot use social action as a major model. Okay, maybe some elements of that can be used, but it depends on the employer and the preferences of the beneficiary. You know, sometimes our beneficiaries may not like to use certain models. Very conflictual, very aggressive kind of advocacy and pressurizing may not be comfortable for certain constituencies. So who are we working for? Our beneficiaries or you know our client groups. So their interests are very, very important. Then their cultural values, needs. You can never go beyond the cultural values of the people with whom we are working. We cannot impose our values, our sense of right and wrong on them, that we all know. Then our theoretical framework, you know, what kind of a theoretical framework do you have? What kind of, you know, are you a right-based, you know, strength-based kind of a perspective person? It depends on that also. It also depends on our personality to some extent, whether you're a conflict mode kind of a person or a consensus mode person. Then, of course, the problem or the situation. Some problems require certain models. It cannot be dealt with by other models. Okay, and the ethical issues related to using certain interventions are also important. So you look at all these things and then you choose your model. Okay, and I have, this was done some 8 or 9 years ago. I just looked at some 12 or 14 NGOs in Kerala, the kind of models they are using. And I found that this is just a summary. I found that the most predominantly used models are locality development and social planning. And of course, social and community development model of Mary Vale. Organizing functional communities are also done. Capacity and awareness promotion is a major model, but we rarely see social action coalition building in our context. I haven't seen much. Of course, there are exceptions, but these other things are most predominantly used. Okay, so I'll conclude now. One thing we should understand that models are, they give us a clear sequence of actions to be taken. in a situation. So this helps us. So we should begin with the basic model. We study should study that well and then develop on that. So this is my presentation. I can definitely take questions and comments also. If you have anything to add, contradict also, it is you're welcome. Thank you for the listening, for listening attentively, and you know, bearing with the technical glitches also. Thank you so much.
Thank you, ma'am. I think father has to leave now.
Okay.
Yeah. So I wish he can say some words before he's leaving. He says that he's having some meeting at 11 o'clock.
Yeah.
So father, can you speak to us before you are leaving?
Yeah. Now 5 minutes time, I have to go. I'm sorry.
Yeah.
Congratulations to you. It was a brilliant presentation, and we are very happy that you have rather elaborately introduced the topic. Yeah, that's fine. You. Yeah. One thing that you know that is very important in the choice of model, it is depends on the perception of the clientele system. It is not that somebody chooses, because if you perceive the community as the problem, as they are poor, you know, citizens, they are poor citizens.
Yeah.
So they don't know what to do, how to do. Then we choose the locality developed model according to Jack Ruthman. That means they are poor because their capacities are not developed. They are backward there because they did not have opportunity. So provide the opportunity. If you look at the history of Kudumbasri, it is typically a locality development model of Jack Ruthman. Okay. Because it has never envisaged the complete change of the society. It is only alleviation of the poverty, some improvement.
Yeah.
Now, if you perceive the community as the poor consumers, because our products are there, situation is there, but poor cannot consume it. So we go there and supply. That is a local the social planning model, where we understand that, you know, you apply and we supply.
Yeah.
Which means, you know, you need a highly professional input in terms of data collection, fundraising, and certain discipline you have to. And as Dr. Jaya said, the participation will be minimal. Participation means they have to stand in a queue, as they have now the queue to collect the food or collect the railway tickets. This is a social planning mode. Now, if think of a social action, it is a perception that the situation happened before they have to defend themselves. And this is very important. That are two levels. One is strategy is that you contest strategy. That you may publicize, bring the issue in the public through difference.
I think father have left the meeting.
I'm back.
I don't think he's left the meeting.
Okay.
There is some problem in connection. Yeah.
Yeah. Okay. One second. Yeah.
Okay, please.
Can you see me now?
Yeah.
We can see you.
Okay. Now the social action model basically talks about issue is being made public, either through reflection, and the poor people themselves get organized. That is a real social action. Here you see that they are victims of system, and they say that you cannot take us for anymore for granted, and therefore we want to respond. It is not revolution in the sense that it is not violence. So there is a legitimacy of the social action in social work. And when there is a violence, we stop action because that is not social work. But we galvanize the people, organize the people, give them awareness about the situation, and to ask them to defend for themselves. And a social worker will have to pay the high price for it. That is why we have very few social action activists among the social workers. Because most of us have paid a lot of money for studies and we have to get a job. And if you are going for social action, most of the organization will throw you out.
Yeah.
Therefore, it is, as Dr. Jaya said, this is a political component. And Jack Ruthman used as a militancy. Militancy is that, asking face to face, saying that, you cannot take us for granted. Give us a right. You know that legislation comes, in terms of protest comes, samaram comes, all these part of the social action. And this is very important. So what I want trying to say that, you know, the our perception of the community, the perception of the clientele system will determine our approach to reality. And community organization, this is very important. It is not that individual's understanding of theoretical, but your commitment, your passion, your creativity, all this become very important. Only a passionate, committed person can develop this model and involve in the social action model. And that is practically the problem that we are facing. And thank you very much. And I have to go. Wish you all the best for the further discussion. Dr. Jaya, it is nice seeing you after a long time. God bless you. Thank you. And you know, a professor always feel very happy that his student does much better than the professor himself. And Jay has been my student many years ago.
It was a bit apprehensive because you are there.
Yeah, I'll always support love. Good. Thank you. God bless you.
Thank you, Father Joy, for your presence. I think we'll have
other questions.
We'll have only 2 minutes left now.
Okay.
If there is more discussion and questions, we can have one more session. I mean, one more 40-minute sessions that we have to again join.
Okay. Okay.
But that will only according to your convenience, ma'am, because if you have some other programs after 11.
If there are questions, I can take it. I don't mind staying back. But if there is not any more questions, I think we can stop. Depends on the...
Okay. So, if there is anything to ask, just as quick as you can ask participants, unmute yourself and ask it.
Hello.
And if there is more questions, then we'll again restart the session.
Yeah.
So, please ask your. There is one question in the chat box that. Can you give us an example of this model, something like that?
Okay, fine. So
before starting if this is cutting, then
okay, we'll have to rejoin.
Yeah.
Okay. The first one, locality development model. I think a large number of NGOs working in communities in Kerala are doing it. So. Going to a community, maybe like, let us say, I would like to give an example of maybe a Jalanidhi project. Okay. Jalanidhi project is a larger one, but you know, in a community or you will have to look at NGO activities. If you are familiar with any NGO during your fieldwork and all, you can see that they organize farmers, they organize women to undertake micro enterprises, livelihood activities. Things like that, and or maybe deal with the social problem of lack of water, some kind of infrastructure facilities not there. So people come together and they work with the help of the social worker or the NGO from the from that part, and then work together to deal with the problem. They might get help from other organizations also. Okay, so that is one example of a locality development kind of intervention. And social, I think it's still continuing. Okay, social planning, as Father said, Kudumbasri is a very good example. A large mass of people are... planning is, we try to provide services to people after collecting information, who needs services, what kind of services and all. So, example will be our public health campaigns, programs like NHM, Kudumbasri and all. That is what we do. We have a massive data on the number of people who live below poverty line. Okay, Kudumbashree is a poverty eradication program. So we collect that data using certain indicators, and then we devise a program based on that. We identify these people who are having problems. We organize them into groups and provide them services. Sometimes it can be microcredit, it can be training, it can be provision of certain services like facilities for a creche while they're working. So you are providing services on a large scale to deal with the problem. Okay, and we can see that social workers in our state are largely employed by such projects, social planning projects. That is the model. It is not named as social planning, but if you look at it through the lens of this particular three models, we can see that it is that is the model being used. we are social workers are working in organizations where large scale services are provided using the information collected and analyzed. That's the second one. Social action, of course, I'm sure everybody is familiar. We have lots of movements, but very few initiated by social workers. But there are efforts to deal with problems which are basically ingrained in social injustice or inequality. Some kind of operation is involved. So you fight for the, you help the people, you organize the people to come together and then fight for the cause. So there are, you know, it is not documented properly. So social workers rarely initiate, as Father said, social action movements, but there are examples. I don't know whether I can say this. One organization, one social work school in Kerala, they have actually identified an environmental issue. They organized, they informed people. That is what they did. They didn't, you know, go out with campaigns and marches and all that. They informed the people living in that place and that, you know, this is a threat. From there on, it was taken up by the people. So it can be, you know, I would say that is a very good example of a social action model initiated by a social work group. Okay, thank you. Any other question? See, one thing I would like to add, if there was no time, that is why I didn't do that. This is only the basic models. In our syllabus, in Calicut University syllabus, it's very clearly, we are studying other models also. We have Gandhiji, of course, which is the most indigenous model we have available with us, which we, all of us should learn and, you know, we should use also. Gandhiji has become more and more relevant today. Today, you know, every morning I think about, you know, what he said and how relevant it is today. So Gandhiji's models should be of non-violence and Sarvodaya. They should be definitely thought about. Then Paulo Freire's models of education for social change and liberation. Then we have Alinsky's model of a little more direct action, kind of, you know, non-violent direct action kind of model. So there are other models also, but we have only discussed the basic. Yeah.
Okay.
Ma'am, there is a question in the last session. From the last session, I have put the question in the chat box. I think you can read it. It's a view sharing, I think.
Okay. This is. Is this the definition of community? Somebody has put the definition of a global definition of community.
Yeah.
Is that the one you're talking about?
Yeah.
Yeah, I think that's okay.
Thank you. This is more, like, you know, it's more global. It is more contemporary. It is a more contemporary definition of a community. Fine. Thank you.
Actually, those who want to speak and share their views and even to add to this, they can unmute themselves and talk. That is better.
Yeah. Rather than...
Putting into Zoom. I mean, chat box. There will be more, like, if there are practitioners, there will be insights from practitioners. Yes. So it's a learning together process, so you can. If there are any other questions from students' part, please ask it in Malayalam. That is,
yeah, please. Thirchayattum. See, if there are no more questions, I would like just to conclude by saying one or two words about the current situation. We are in a place where we have never expected us to be. Like, namukku ariyam valare adi bhayangaramaya oru sahajaryathile nammal undu. Appo thirchayattum ee community work ennu parayunnathinte relevance valare pradhanam, especially ee rebuilding this community. Nammalde aa oru namukku, we have lost, as Father said, your principal said in the beginning, we have lost lives, we have lost property, our economy is in trouble. So it means സാധാരണക്കാരനെ സംബന്ധിച്ചിടത്തോളം ഈ പറയുന്നതിന്റെ ഒക്കെ അർത്ഥം കൂടുതൽ ബുദ്ധിമുട്ടുകൾ എന്നാണ്. സോ വി ഹാവ് ടു റീബിൽഡ് അവർ കമ്മ്യൂണിറ്റീസ്, വി ഹാവ് ടു സ്റ്റാർട്ട് വർക്കിംഗ് അബൌട്ട് വിത്ത് ഫുഡ് സെക്യൂരിറ്റി. ദാറ്റ് ഇസ് എ മോസ്റ്റ് ഇമ്പോർട്ടൻറ്റ് തിങ് ഐ തിങ്ക് ദിസ് ക്രൈസിസ് ഹാസ് ഓപ്പൺഡ് അവർ ഐസ് ടു ദ ഇഷ്യൂ ഓഫ് ഫുഡ് സെക്യൂരിറ്റി. ഓക്കെ, ആൻഡ് ബീങ് സെൽഫ് സഫിഷ്യൻ. ഐ കം ടു ദിസ് ഗാന്ധിയൻ ഐഡിയൽ അഗൈൻ, യു നോ, ബീങ് സെൽഫ് സഫിഷ്യൻ ആൻഡ് സെൽഫ് റിലയൻറ്റ്, പ്രൊഡ്യൂസിങ് അവർ ഓൺ ഫുഡ്. സോ ദീസ് ആർ ദ they may sound small to us, but as social workers, I think we have a responsibility to work with communities to build on that. You know, building livelihoods, sustainable livelihoods, which will not fall down. It's such a threat. Our livelihoods are right now, they are not sustainable. It can, you know, go wrong in one small disaster. So we have to start thinking about sustainable livelihoods. We have to definitely think about, you know, food security issues. Cultivating our food and managing our food and not, you know, making sure that food does not become a weapon of injustice. It is not appropriated by certain people and it's not available to people. So these issues are there. So definitely community work has got a lot of opportunities, a lot of things to do. We have a lot bigger space today. So I think that is the thing you should take from this webinar. That is my hope. Shall I conclude now? I'm concluding my comments. I'm very happy that around